Hello friends, welcome back to the Dynamic Cast, one place for reviews, recipes, crafts and much more. Are you an iPhone user and planning to switch to an Android phone for whatever reasons? Are you worried that you have some important chats, messages, attachments and media on your WhatsApp and how will you transfer the same to your new Android phone? If that is the case, this video is for you. In this video, we will see a proven method of transforming your entire WhatsApp from iPhone to Android. Friends, hope you all are doing fine in the current situation of the pandemic. Please take good care of yourself, your family and your loved ones. The second wave in India is very aggressive and dangerous. Don't take it lightly. Maintain social distancing, wear masks, do not go out unless absolutely necessary. Let's pray for all those who lost their lives due to this pandemic. Before we start the video, first things first. If you have not subscribed to our channel, then please do so immediately and press the bell icon button so that you get the notification about our upcoming videos as soon as they are uploaded. Now, let's get started. A clarification before we start. This is not a sponsored video. This is my personal experience as I recently switched from my iPhone 6s to Samsung Galaxy S20 FE 5G and I did some research for several hours on this topic. As usual, I started with Google and YouTube video to understand how to do this transfer, and as usual, there are hundreds of YouTube videos and articles on this topic. However, one thing which was very clear during my research was that more than 95% of the videos articles are sponsored. They ultimately point you to a paid software ranging from $40 to $120, and obviously that is not something that one wants to spend after spending so much on purchasing a new mobile. So first, let's understand why so much of hue and cry about transferring WhatsApp from your old iPhone to new Android phone. Why not back up the data to your cloud storage and restore it? Well, it's not that simple. There are two major reasons. One, iPhone stores the WhatsApp backup into iCloud, whereas Android saves it into Google Drive. Second, since WhatsApp does end-to-end encryption, both have different formats and cannot be just copied from one format to another one. So transferring WhatsApp from your old iPhone to Android phone is not straightforward, as you might have done from an Android to Android phone or an iPhone to another iPhone. While there is a news that WhatsApp is working on such a feature, they will allow cross-platform migration of messages. However, as we speak, there is no official release date for such feature. So after spending several hours on researching this topic, I found an easiest and cheapest way to transfer the data. Here is the quick highlight of the process that I followed to successfully transfer the data from my iPhone to Android phone. Using iTunes app on Windows 10, I took a backup of my iPhone on laptop. Approximately 65 gigs of data took around 1.5 hours. Using WM Extractor underscore Windows utility, extracted WhatsApp database and media on the laptop. 16 gigs of WhatsApp data took about 1 hour. The utility can be found at https://www.whatsappmigrator.com/WM Extractor. The link of the same can be found in the description below. Copied WhatsApp database file, chat storage.sqlite and media folder to my Android phone. It took about 1 hour for copying using Type-C cable. Installed WhatsApp Migrator app on my Android phone by paying ₹620 for this. Ran WhatsApp Migrator and followed the on-screen instruction. This step took about 4.5 hours. As my WhatsApp backup was quite large, approximately 16 gigabytes. It required uninstall and reinstall WhatsApp at step number 5, but finally I had my WhatsApp on Android phone. In this process, it skipped some media file indicating the file format not compatible error. It is very lengthy and involved process and took about 8 hours to complete the entire process end to end and required a lot of patience. Now, let's deep dive and see how the process works. Before starting the process, go to your iPhone and disable the iCloud backup in settings. Also, Ensure that if the Gmail account being used on your Android phone is associated with any other WhatsApp number and contains a WhatsApp backup on Google Drive, disable or delete the backup from your Google Drive. Now install and open iTunes app. I am using this on Windows 10 laptop. Connect your phone to the laptop using the data cable and let iTunes detect your phone. Click on the phone icon to open the phone management screen. Now go to backup section, select this computer option and ensure to uncheck encrypt local backup. Then click backup now. Depending upon the data size of your iPhone, it will take few minutes to few hours to generate a successful backup. Once backup is done, go to https://wasappmigrator.com/wmextractor, download and install the WM Extractor utility on the same laptop where you have taken the iPhone backup. Run this utility, you will see this screen. The utility will automatically detect the backup and show the WhatsApp file as this. Then click on the extract button and let the utility extract WhatsApp files for you. Again, depending upon the size of your WhatsApp data, it may take few minutes to few hours. In my case, the data was 16 gigabytes and it took about 1 hour to extract this. Once the extraction is completed, the utility will ask you if you want to upload the backup to your Google Drive. You can ignore and exit the utility. The utility will create the WhatsApp backup in your download folder under extracted from iTunes backup folder. Check the folder size and note down the number of files and folders in this folder. Now connect your Android phone to laptop using data cable. Now go to WhatsApp backup folder on your laptop and copy chatstorage.sql file and media folder and paste it into your Android phone in download folder. If you have a Type-C connector on your phone and a Type-C port on your laptop, use the Type-C to Type-C cable for faster data transfer. Now on your Android phone, go to Google Play Store and search for WhatsApp Migrator and install the same. Note that this is a paid app and I had to pay ₹620 for the same. Once installed, start the app and it will automatically detect WhatsApp backup file on your downloads folder. Now follow the on-screen instruction and click on the play button and the app will start the transfer process. Be patient at this point in time. It may take few minutes to few hours. One by one, each checklist item will be completed and you will reach at the final items of converting messages. Once the entire process is complete, you will see a transfer report as this. Click on OK and follow the on-screen instruction. The app will automatically download WhatsApp version in the form of APK from their website and not from Google Play Store. Install the same. You may need to enable and trust the APK installation in your phone setting. Once done, WhatsApp will start automatically and it will identify a local backup in your phone. Click continue and let WhatsApp restore the backup. Once done, it will prompt you to uninstall the WhatsApp and install the new one from the Play Store. Follow the same and start the WhatsApp, enter your phone number and click next. The latest WhatsApp from Play Store will detect backup in your local phone and try to restore. Click next at this point in time. Boom! You are done with your WhatsApp transfer and ready to use it on your Android phone. Few things to take care in this entire process. Patience, patience, patience. Very important. This process is very long and involved and you need to be patient. Follow the on-screen instructions exactly. If you have a spare WhatsApp account, try to restore it on your sample account rather than using your original WhatsApp number to avoid messing up your WhatsApp account. Note, this is done based on my experience. Depending upon your phone software and model, it may have different process and options. We are sharing this to help you out and not responsible for any data loss or any other issues. There are many sophisticated paid apps ranging from $30 to $120 which claim to do this in much easier way, but I could not evaluate their reliability and security as they need to be online. The process I am explaining here is a complete offline process and you can run it even keeping your phone in airplane mode. Please share your views about this video in comment section. If you have any query, do write it in the comment section and we will try to answer the same. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for our upcoming videos. Please subscribe and press the bell icon button to get the notification about the same.